Hello and welcome to another outdoor tutorial in monitoring of forest resources. My name is Lutz Fehrmann and we are here in a forest area about 20 kilometers northwest of Göttingen. As you can see in the background, it's a mixed forest with conifers and also broadleaf trees. And in this video, I like to introduce the Vertex instrument by the company Haglöf from Sweden. This instrument is interesting for us since it can measure two things. It can measure vertical angles, so inclination angles, and it can measure distances. What makes it so interesting for forest inventory work is that the distance is here measured based on ultrasonic sound. And for this purpose, we need a second active component in this system, which is the so-called transponder. So the distance between the transponder and the device is measured by ultrasonic sound. And that enables us also to measure through dense understory, as you can see in the background. In order to make the system working, we first need to switch on the transponder by just holding it close to the device and just pressing the first button here. And if you hear two beeps, then the transponder is on. If you switch it off, you hear six beeps. If I would like to measure a tree height, and I have identified a tree here in the background, I need to fix this transponder on the tree bark. And this is what I will do now. One thing before I do this is important to mention. Since the sound of speed is very much influenced by the temperature and also by air humidity, we need to calibrate this system before we start working or whenever the conditions are changing. This is done by a fixed distance of 10 meters, and I've done this before. I will not show it to you, but you can look it up in the manual. Once the device is calibrated, I can measure a distance between the transponder and the device, in this case 70 centimeters. And I can even measure a distance from the left side of my head to the right side of my head, which is 56 centimeters in this case. So this is the very interesting characteristic of measuring with a sound tape. I will now go and fix this transponder on the tree for which I'm going to measure the tree height, which is a large tree in this direction. Okay, I've now fixed the transponder on the tree that I'm going to measure, and I did that exactly in 1.3 meters height because this is what I set here in the settings menu as a transponder height. If I like to measure a tree height, I now switch on the device with the red button here and navigate to the menu height, and I confirm this again with the red button. Now I look through this small window here and you see in your view a red cross. And with this red cross, I aim exactly on the height of the transponder. The transponder is here behind quite dense understory, but I can still see it. I aim to the transponder and I press the red button until I hear a beep. With this first measurement, we measure two different things. First of all, the slope distance to the transponder, but also the inclination angle to the transponder. The device can calculate the horizontal distance, and the only remaining measurement that we need now is the angle to the top of the tree. So I aim to the top of the tree and I press the button again until I hear a beep. I have now measured my first tree height. From the same position, from the same distance, I can measure up to six heights. If I'm, for example, interested in a commercial height, I can measure up to the lower branches of the crown to take an additional measurement from which I can also derive the crown length. So I have now measured 30.2 meters for the total height of this tree and 17 meters for the commercial height of this tree. We can also use the vertex just to measure distances. And for this purpose, I need to switch it on before, I can put the transponder also on this sound mirror here. So this is a sound mirror that mirrors the sound signal in 360 degrees around this position. And I can now measure the distance to this position from any point in the surrounding. That is a very flexible sound tape that is also very useful for plot assessments, and we will come back to this later. Well, measuring with sound seems to be a very interesting alternative. But this advantage is at the same time also the disadvantage of this device. Because there might be situations where you have interfering sound signals. In the tropics, this might be, for example, insects, or it might be wind blowing through grasses. It might even be the sound of raindrops if they fall on the leaves in the canopy that can interfere with the signal in this ultrasonic sound receiver. And that sometimes leads to wrong distance measurements, and in some cases you can even not use the device at all. So therefore it's always a good idea to have a backup instrument in your pocket. Okay, this is what I wanted to tell you about the Vertex. We come back to this instrument later. Thank you very much for watching so far, and see you in one of our next tutorials where we will cover other devices.